Welcome back to CAD/CAM tutorial. Today we are going to study about SOLIDWORKS pipe routing, how to use the pipe routing tool and create a pipe assembly in SOLIDWORKS with the help of design library. Very many subscribers asked me about pipe routing, so here we will do a simple and basic tutorial of pipe routing. We will create this assembly with the help of design library. We have a very strong routing library, so let's see how to do this in SOLIDWORKS. Now here let's choose here file, new, and go to assembly. Okay, now once you enter the SOLIDWORKS assembly window, now here we will learn about SOLIDWORKS pipe routing tutorials. Here we will create a simple pipe geometry with the help of routing tutorial, or we will use the design library to create a simple pipe geometry. So let's see how to do this one. First you have to activate the SOLIDWORKS routing option. So just go to drop down the window of option add-ins, and here you will find SOLIDWORKS routing option. Just click this one. I'll tell you the important thing: SOLIDWORKS routing option only available in SOLIDWORKS premium version. Those who have professional and standard, they will not get this option. Select OK. Here it will ask you yes, continue to load SOLIDWORKS routing. That's it. Once you enter the SOLIDWORKS routing option, let me change the background, and I'll always keep the quality little higher. Now just go to design library, and if you come down, here you will find routing option. Once you drop down this menu of routing option, we will create a simple piping assembly. So we will go to piping option. See, there are many options in piping. Let's choose flanges. In piping you will see here there are three types of flange, so we will select one flange, slip on weld flange. So just drag it. Now it will show you the options, what are the configuration and what are the options available. So we will choose here slip on flange 150 NPS 1.5. Select OK. It will ask you like to save the assembly. Select yes and save the assembly anywhere. OK. Now a routing properties window will pop up. So it is by default. So just select OK. Now see. Now you can see a simple flange with simple pipe. Now you can do one thing, you just select this end point and drag, and see the pipe position automatically drags. Now we will do one thing, select here line, and we want to expand this one. So go to the opposite direction of pipe. See, now we want to go upward direction. Now here if you want to change the direction of arrow, so just press tab. Exit. Now see, we created a simple geometry with the help of piping tool. Now we have multiple options. We can change this one, choose smart dimension, select this one. Let's make 250 mm, 300 mm, 250 mm, 350 mm, or let's make 300 mm. Select here OK. Now there is one more option. Just go to design library, and below the flange you will find one option, reducer. If you want to put reducer, just drag one reducer, this red color, drag at the end point. Select OK. Now it will show you the suitable reducer which is going to fit to this pipe. So these are the reducers. Our pipe size is 1.5, so we will choose first one. OK. It will ask you, do you need anything changes or anything? Select cancel. It means it is going to ask you, you need extra or anything. So we don't need. Now see. Now select. Again, we will put one flange at the end. So select, drag flange and take this point. And here it will ask you if you want a bigger or a smaller and anything. It will shows you only suitable option which is going to fit on this option. So let's select bigger one. Select here no. Now see. Now suppose here we want to add some pipe or flange. So there is one more option. Just choose the line command and draw one vertical line. You can change the dimension with the help of arrow. It's up to you. Exit. Now this pipe is created. Just again go to design library and choose your flange and drag one flange to the end of this point, and it will automatically take the position. Now last time we took the pipe 150 nps 1.5. now here we will choose 150 nps 1. So it's, or let's keep some little difference. Now see, it's look is small. Choose here OK. Now right click on this pipe and select here penetrate. If you will select penetrate, it will penetrate fully inside. Now it is asking you our elbow size is not 90 degree, or use the setting for all other identical. Use default alternate elbow, select OK. Bend angle greater than, select OK. So we need to change the elbow size, because according to pipe diameter it is not suitable. So select 40, OK. Now that's it. Now see, all the elbow is going to fixed. Now select here, exit. Now exit. Now see, pipe, elbow and flange, everything is ready. You can just hide this geometry. By default it will hide. Now you can see there are many number of components, slip, reducer, or there are many things, reducer, pipe and flange. If you want to save this, save it and see the all option going to save all. Okay, I choose inside the assembly. If you will go otherwise, it will save all separately. Now just go to section view and we will see. Okay, now see, due to penetrate command, it will perfectly penetrate and you can see the option. Okay, so this is the simple command of pipe route, or simple tools of pipe routing. You can create your own pipeline or your own pipe assembly in SolidWorks with the help of routing tools. So these are the basic tools. We will see here in future, we will see more complicated and more interesting projects with the help of pipe routing. Now after saving this assembly, even if you want to see, just select this part, right click, open. Now see, now here you can separately see this pipe, elbow and each and every part. Okay, now just click on the pipe, open. Now see, this is the our standard pipe what we took. From here you can take the dimension even separately, cancel, even though your reducer, open. See, this is the your reducer. So from here you can see separately each and every part which is going to be used in our assembly. I hope you like it. Don't forget to share and like our video, and please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. If you have any questions, just write down below. I'll try to answer each and every question. I hope you like it. Thanks for watching.